Welcome to everyone. Today we are going to learn about astrophysics. Shortly presented by Department of Physics, Idea College for Women, Kumbakonam. Science is but an image of the truth.
Okay guys, let we get into the astrophysics.
Astrophysics is a branch of space science, and it explains the birth, life and death of stars, planets, galaxies, nebulae and other objects in the universe. It has two sibling science. One is astronomy and other is cosmology. Astronomy. What is astronomy? The study of celestial objects, space and the physical universe. Cosmology. What is cosmology? The study of the universe.
Astrophysicists try to understand the intricacies of our universe by examining the things like solar system, stars, black hole and other relevant parts of our cosmology. First, we move on to the explanation of solar system.
Solar system is the part of universe in which sun occupies the central position, and the solar system consists of 8 planets. They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. The 8 planets are revolving around the sun. The sun is in the central position of the 8 planets. Mercury. It is the smallest planet of the solar system. It is nearest to the sun and revolves around the sun in 89 days. And it takes 176 days to rotate itself. Venus. It is the hottest planet because of carbon dioxide. It completes one revolution in 225 days. Earth. Earth is the only planet of the solar system having life on it. Earth has only one natural satellite named as Moon. Mars. It is the second smallest planet in the solar system. It has two moons and revolves in 687 days. Jupiter. It is the largest planet of the solar system. It has 79 moons. Saturn. It is the only planet with a ring around it. It is the second largest planet of the solar system. Uranus. It is the coldest planet. William Herschel discovered this planet in 1781. It has 27 moons. Neptune. It was discovered in 1846 by French astronomer called Eugène Leverrier. It has 14 moons. Pluto. Well, Pluto also considered as a planet, but in 2006 it was considered as dwarf planet. It has 0 rings and 5 moons.
Star. A star began its life inside a vast molecular clouds of dust and gas. These molecular clouds are also known as nebula or dark nebula. They mostly contain hydrogen and helium molecule along with some other particles. These molecular clouds contain a large amount of gravity. Due to its high gravity, it began to collapse on itself, then causing hydrogen and helium to clump together. Thus increasing the mass in the center of the cloud, it increases the gravitational pull, thus attracting even more molecules and particles from the surrounding. As more and more molecules and particles collapse or fall into the center of the cloud, the center begins to heat up. This heated center is known as protostar. At last, the star is born.
Black hole. In night times, we usually watch stars in the sky. But in this part of video, you are all going to get some knowledge about how the star is getting changes into black hole.
Shall we get into the black hole?
Yeah. First of all, we see what is black hole. A black hole is a region of space-time where gravity is so strong that nothing, no particle, or even electromagnetic radiation such as light cannot escape from it, it gets attracted to the black hole. For simplicity, I am taking Sun for the explanation of black hole. The Sun has the 99.6% of total mass in the solar system. Due to the heavy mass in the Sun, it also has a strong gravitational force. In the core of the Sun, it has a large amount of pressure. Due to the presence of gravitational force in the Sun, the core may get collapsed. But it does not get collapsed. How it is possible? It is possible due to the high pressure in the Sun, it fuses the two hydrogen atoms to form a helium atom by the process of nuclear fusion. This helium atom releases a large amount of energy. The energy from the helium atom makes the Sun as a stable star. After 5 billion years, two helium atoms in the Sun fuse to form a carbon atom. But for fusioning the carbon atom, the Sun does not have the required pressure in it, so that it bursts out. Then the remaining other of mass of Sun is reduced to the size of Earth. It is known as white dwarf. The stars only with a mass of 8 times of the Sun, it only able to change as a white dwarf. I am going to take a star of mass that 8 to 20 times larger than the Sun. These stars only able to fuse carbon into neon, neon into oxygen, oxygen into silicon, silicon into ion. When the star gets the iron atom in its core, after the fusion process, it is nearer to the end of its lifetime. This iron atom absorbs all energy from that star. Then the nuclear fusion has been stopped. This iron atom then get fused with the electron, proton and subatomic particles of the star forms a neutron. In that neutron, due to a very high gravity, it compressed to a pressure of neutron degenerative pressure. Due to the heavy pressure, the star get exploded as a supernova explosion. If the mass of the core left after the supernova explosion has mass between 1.44 and 2.8 times of the mass of the Sun, then it becomes a neutron star. The presence of proton and neutron in the outer layer of the core produces a strong magnetic field in its rotation. The gravitational field in the neutron star is billion times greater than the Earth. The escape velocity of the neutron star is half of the speed of light. Due to very small size of the core, it rotates 100 to 700 times rotation per second. Neutron degenerative pressure means the two neutrons placed in a balanced pressure. When a star overcomes a neutron degenerative pressure, it explodes as a supernova explosion forms a black hole. We are part of this universe, we are in this universe, but perhaps more important than both of those facts is that the universe is in us. Said by Neil deGrasse Tyson. Thank you.